School districts across Pennsylvania are taking allegations of bullying more seriously than ever before.
And for good reason. But is it possible for a school district to be too aggressive in how it handles those allegations? New at 6, two local families say yes. And they've turned to Team 4 investigative reporter Jim Parsons to tell their story.
Yeah, Andrew and Michelle, this all started last school year. And it was actually since last March that the Franks and the Gaus families of Butler County say they've been trying to get an explanation from Seneca Valley School administrators. They want to know why their daughters were pulled out of class and interrogated by a police officer without the parents' knowledge.
I just didn't know what to think and, like, if anyone was going to believe us.
Megan Gaus and twin sisters Samantha and Michelle Franks deny they ever bullied another student at Seneca Valley High School. They were never disciplined for it, but Jackson Township Police and school administrators did call them to the office about it last March. The girls say it was an interrogation.
Because at the point when we were sitting in the main office, we could hear him screaming at Megan, and that's when we actually realized that something must have been wrong.
The girls say administrators and police tried to get them to admit to bullying another girl with text messages.
The dean said that I could be trialed and taken out in handcuffs and fined and put on probation and all this stuff if I didn't tell the truth.
It was just handled very badly in my mind.
The girls' parents say the high school didn't call them until police and administrators were finished grilling their kids.
If the police can show up on Seneca Valley School property and pull these kids out of class and interrogate them without phoning the parents, they can do it to any child that goes to Seneca Valley.
Seneca Valley administrators and Jackson Township Police declined to comment to Team 4, but district policy says when police request permission to interrogate a student at school, the principal shall attempt to inform the student's parents. And ACLU legal director Vic Walchek tells Team 4 police should not be questioning minors in school without parental involvement. There is too much opportunity for coercion without a parent present.
You get 14-year-olds in an office with somebody that's been screaming with a police officer, you are going to be intimidated, no doubt about it. So they put them in a bad situation right from the get-go.
Now, the girls were never charged by police or disciplined by the school. Their families want an admission from district administrators that they violated school policy. Meantime, what should parents tell their children to do in that kind of a situation? Well, the ACLU's Vic Walchek says students always have the option of telling the principal that they want to call their parents. And administrators certainly, I think, would agree to that. Mm-hmm. If a child said, I want to call my mom or dad.
Sure.
Of course.
It's going to get a lot of parents' attention, though. Everybody's going to be checking their own school's policy in their own district.
Exactly. And there is some guidance on this on the Safe School Act in Harrisburg. So, and their policy at Seneca Valley does mirror what the State Safe School Act says. It's just the parents here say they didn't follow it in this case.
All right. Jim, thank you very much. Okay.